I managed to turn 22 this year. With a healthy diet and regular exercise, I have, let's say, 60 years left to live on this planet. But when looking at the state of the world as we know it, I ask myself, does it have 60 years left? Because over these 22 years, I've seen a concern for a changing climate turn into the existential threat that is the ever-worsening climate crisis. Just have a look at this. Here, not far from my home, a monument to our misdeeds is being carved into the German landscape. A lignite strip mining field so enormous that these excavators almost look like toys. But for your understanding of the scale of this image, if you took the Eiffel Tower and laid it on its side, that's roughly the length, width, and weight as one of those machines. It is a testament to our enormous need for fossil fuels and what this need does to our planet. But what is there to do about this gigantic hole? Frankly, not a lot. As with others like it, it will be recultivated and turned into an artificial lake. Nature will be restored with time, because there's a clear plan on how this will come to an end. But is there a clear plan on how we're going to end the climate crisis? Well, the latest report of the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, the IPCC, gives us the clearest insights yet on what to expect for the future of our world. And I want to share some of those insights with you. Now, firstly, to be absolutely clear, human activities are to blame for the warming of the Earth, and there's no doubt about it. Secondly, under all the scenarios in this report, global temperatures will keep rising until 2050. And unless greenhouse gas emissions are reduced drastically, the 2 degrees mark will be reached by the year 2100. Now, thirdly, this 2 degrees rise in global temperatures means that heavy rainfall, flooding, sea level rise, as well as heat spells and droughts, as well as many other so-called climate impact drivers, will become more severe and more frequent. And the consequences of these changes cascade down into all aspects of life on Earth. And yet, the Netherlands, a country that is almost one-fifth water, still produces 92% of its energy from fossil fuels. I mean, come on, guys. What's your plan here? We know you can build amazing infrastructure to keep water at bay, but unless we get this under control, you're going to get your shoes wet. So what this means for me is that we need to reduce global emissions to zero as fast as possible. However, I'm old enough to understand that achieving this will be extremely difficult, because it requires that we change our established ways drastically. But I'm also young and hopeful enough to believe that we can do it. As a design student here at the Fontys University of Applied Sciences in Venlo, I worked on a project for the municipality of Venlo. As a group of students, we were asked to communicate to the public how an innovative technology could be part of the solution that helps the Netherlands transition away from burning fossil fuels in the future. It's called surface water thermal energy systems, and it aims to replace natural gas for in-home heating by instead getting this good energy from water sources all around us. Because heating our rooms makes up the biggest share of energy we use in our homes. And I haven't even touched on the growing need for cooling yet. But here's the deal. It can do that too. So let me give you a basic explanation of how it works. There are several pieces involved. A home, or even an entire neighborhood. A nearby body of water, like a lake or a river. Underground storage for cold and warm water. And crucially, heat exchangers. Now here's how it works. First, in the summer, as you see, when there's a demand for cooling, cold water is pumped up from the underground storage through the heat exchangers to cool down your rooms, so you don't have to sweat. Now, this slightly warmer water is then heated further by the warmth of the nearby source of water, which is then stored underground, where it is kept until it is needed again. For the winter months, for example, where this entire system is basically just run backwards. So you take the heat from the underground storage, pump it through the heat exchanger to heat your room to a cozy temperature, whereby this water cools down and is stored again underground so that it can be used again to repeat the same cycle in the summer. Of course, it's more technical and complex than this, but conceptually, I think that's quite clever. And on a large enough scale, systems like this can have great potential. Just look at Iceland, where they make use of their unique geographic location and produce around 80% of their energy from renewable sources, like hydropower and geothermal energy. So too, could the Netherlands harness their intense relationship with water to reduce emissions. Because, like I said, with around 19% of its total area being covered in water, the Netherlands are the perfect place to employ such a technology and to develop it further. But it's not exclusive. All around the world, thermal energy from surface water can be used to heat our homes and help us reduce our dependency on fossil fuels for heating, while already having a solution for cooling built-in. Honestly, that sounds amazing. Maybe even too amazing. That's why I have to be clear that a system like this still requires that we run our world on renewable electricity. However, it is one more tool at our disposal to help us transition towards a low-emission future. And realistically, it will still take a long time until all our homes are heated like this. So, if you want to take personal action to reduce your impact on the climate, there's a lot you can do from inside your four walls, starting with turning down your heaters by a degree or two, and ending with completely renovating your home to be as sustainable as possible. No matter the scale of your actions, they all matter because they show a willingness to do the right thing. But most importantly, it is our awareness, our support, and our collective activism towards changing how we will power our world for generations to come that will be our way towards a livable future. So that on my 80th birthday, we can look back at how much we have changed for the better. Thank you.